Hi friends! In this video, I share with you a quiz game project based on artificial intelligence. I will guide you step by step how to achieve like this results. As we see, it's a virtual quiz game. You can select in the air any choice using your hand, especially your index finger. You can put any number of questions you want. You can now also, in the final of the quiz, how many questions did you answer correctly? So if you are interested, stay with me. You will find the full source code below the video. I share with you this link. We have two scripts, virtual quiz file. This is the Python code. And quiz.csv, which contains the question of the quiz. So let's move to install the important libraries. In my case, I used Anaconda. To do that, go into CMD and click in the launch, and you will find the libraries or the command which allows you to install the important libraries in the description part. We need NumPy, Mediapip, OpenCv and CvZone. Just copy this command and pass it here and type enter. In my case, I install all the libraries. So let's take a look about the code. I am using Spider IDE. First, I import all the necessary libraries. I use CV2, CSV, and CvZone, and the time. To make everything clear, I create a question class and initialize the constructor with each line from CSV file. So let's take a near look about CSV file and see the data structure of this file. Here we have a question, choice 1, choice 2, 3 and 4, and finally we have answer. I separate between this data by comma. As an example, this is the question: how many corners does a triangle have? This is the choices, and finally to represent the right answer. So this is the data structure of CSV file. So as we see here, I initialize the question, choice 1, 2, 3, 4, and finally we have the answer. And this is the user answer, which initialized by none in the constructor. We will see the update function inside the class later. Here we need to detect the hand before the finger. So this function allows me to detect the hand using Mediapip library. Here to set up the frame of the camera, and here I import the CSV file with open, as we see here, and I separate between data by this, and I store the result in the reader, and this data all it's a table which contains the data of the reader beginning from the one until the end. Why here I began by one to avoid the first line. This is just to show us the data structure of CSV file. So I began from here till the end. For that I put one here. I store all the objects of the question class inside question list, as we see here, for q in data all, I create new object of question class and store it in question list. So this is just to show us the length of question lists. Here we have question number to track how many question I pass, and total question, the length of data all. So here we have an infinite loop, as we see, while true. So I read the image and I flip it. After that, I put here flip type equals false. So here to detect the hands, here if we delete this line, we can delete this line and make flip type equals true, because by default equals true. Finds hands in BG year image. So this function allows us to find the hands. If question number less than total question, so here this lines to draw the question with the rectangle and the choices. So here we have image and question, which comes from the class choice 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is the position of the rectangle with the text. Here 1 represents the scale and number 2 represents the thickness. This number represents x axis and this y axis. So let's execute. As we see here, this is the position of the question, and here all this the position of choices. Here if I detect just one hand, I do that. So here we have LM list properties. You can see the Mediapip website for more details. I initialize the cursor by LM list 8. So this is the landmark 8. So this is the position 8. So here I try to calculate the distance, as we see, find the distance between two landmarks based on their index number. So I measure the distance between 8 and 12. If the length less than 60, so I call the update function inside question class. So let's see the update function. B box represents bounding box. So this is the cursor. So here I enter this block just if the distance less than 60. So let's see the update function. I initialize this variables by bounding box. So here if the cursor 0 in x axis and 1 in y axis. So if this number between x1 and x2. So this means if the landmark number 8 inside the rectangle. So here this variable to track the answer. Here I put x plus 1 because the answer inside CSV file began from 1. As we see here, 1, 2. As we see here, 2. So here I began from 1, not 0. For that, I put here x plus 1. And also, I try to change the color of the rectangle. So let's see that. So here, I think this color green. So as we see, if I put the index number 8 inside the bounding box and also the distance between my these two finger less than 60, as we see here, the color change, and this is represents I answered the question. So after that, here I show the answer user, so you can delete this line. And here, if question user answer is not none, so I keep the program wait for 0.4 second. Why I put that? So this line allows me to pass into next question. If I delete it, for example, if I choose the first choice, the program came into end fastly. And for each question, I choose the first choice. For that, I make that. If I avoid it, when I make my choice, the program go into end and doesn't allow me to see the second question. I increment the question number here to pass into next question. So if I do this block, else here to calculate the score, because I finish from all the question. So else, so this block allows me to calculate the score. So here I check from the user answer. If the answer is correct, I increment the score, and here I show the scores as a percentage. And also I make quiz completed and I put here the score. And this block repeated always. Here to show the progress bar and how number of question I pass. And finally, if I type Q, the program stop. So this is the filled rectangle and this is just the border without I filled the rectangle. So I make this technique just as I told you to show how many number of question I pass. I wish the code helps you and we will meet in another videos.